4 or 5 minutes, let everyone enter, then I will start. And in the meantime, the procession will be also over. Otherwise, very difficult to talk. It's a huge noise. I hope everybody can see the screen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Oh, ki noise re baba. Jigaram bilokto paro. Okay, today I will continue my discussion on definite integral. We have already discussed what is definite integral, what are improper integrals, what are the properties of definite integral, and how definite integral can be evaluated by using those properties. So these things we have already discussed before this holiday season. And then we will now discuss two special type of definite integral, definite and obviously improper type of integral, beta and gamma functions, which occurs in many physical situations in engineering and physics. We often use these results based on beta and gamma functions. So it is very useful to, it is very necessary also to study beta and gamma functions separately. Now, first of all, let us give the definition of beta and gamma function. First one is gamma function, beta function. Beta function is this 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x whole to the power n minus 1 dx. Clearly, m and n are treated as constant within the integral. The integration variable is x. So m and n are parameters. These are called parameters. These are two parameters. Now, you can easily understand that if you evaluate this definite integral and if you put x is equal to 1 to 0, this upper lower limit 1 to 0, so that will become a function of only m and n. There will be no x. Is it clear? If I suppose I evaluate this thing, that evaluation, after evaluation, I get some function fx. fx and some m and n value will be there as constant. Now we evaluate this integral in the result of the integral from 1 to 0. So we put x is equal to 1 minus x is equal to 0. So that will give us some expression having only m and n. Okay. So this function, this is called a function of m and n. This is called beta function of two parameter m and n. Beta function of two parameter m and n. Okay, before going further, two main things should be first of all mentioned. One is this is an improper integral. This is an improper integral because if you put zero, so at the point zero there is a improperness because zero to the power some m minus one, if this m minus one is some fraction or something, zero to the power something is not defined in this way. And similarly at the upper limit one, so one minus x is again zero. So at this both the upper and lower limit there is a improperness, not finite value. That is the point number one. And point number two is m and n must be positive numbers, not necessarily integer. It can be fraction, maybe m equal to half, n equal to one third, no problem, but it cannot be negative. Okay, so the integral will be convergent if and only if m greater than 0, n greater than 0. This is to be understood clearly. So if the integral is not convergent, there is no meaning of calculating this integral. If this value of this integral is infinity, then we cannot handle this type of thing, infinite or undefined. So the value of the integral must be finite. Okay, so this integral, the value will be finite only when m and n both are greater than 0, may not be same or may not be integer also, but only condition is they are greater than 0. Okay, now if these all these conditions are satisfied, then this function is called beta mn or bmn. Sometimes it is written beta also, and that is also called the first Eulerian integral or beta function. Okay, this is our first function we have defined. The second one is the gamma function. That is defined by 0 to infinity e to the power minus x, x to the power n minus 1. Again, it is an improper integral because at 0, 0 to the power something is not defined. So that is an improperness. And then infinity, so infinity to the power n minus 1 is not defined. So here also upper and lower end are improper. So this is again an improper integral, and that will be convergent only when n greater than 0. Again, n should be greater than 0. It can be fraction, no problem, but it must be greater than 0. So these integrals again have a definite value which is denoted by gamma n. Similarly, so this gamma n has only one parameter n, and beta mn has two parameter beta m bmn mn, two parameters mn. Okay, and the second gamma n is also called second Eulerian integral. So these two functions are very much important in our applied mathematics and engineering. So we will study their properties carefully. So let us study their properties. The first property will be beta mn equal to beta nm. That means if we interchange the parameter, the value will not change. Okay. So how to show this thing? This is very simple. Just put 1 minus x equal to y. Okay, 1 minus x equal to y. Before that, we write it in the way we evaluate the improper integral. Since 0 is a point of improperness, so we evaluate this integral just after 0. So we take one epsilon, which is just greater than 0. Epsilon is tends to 0 plus. That is slightly greater than 0. And up to 1 minus delta. That is, we are integrating just before 1. So delta is again a positive number. So 1 minus delta will be just less than 1. So just greater than 0 to just less than 1, I am integrating. We are just actually omitting these two endpoints, 0 and 1. So this way we are writing.
Sir, why we are using delta function?
Not delta function. Delta is just a value, not delta function. Delta and epsilon are two very small values. Okay, because at this 1 and 0, the integrals are sometime undefined. 0 to the power some fraction. Can you define it? 0 to the power some 1 third. Okay, that is why in order to omit these things, actually we are not taking into consideration these endpoints. Is it clear? We are not taking into consideration these endpoints. We are just taking slightly greater than 0 to slightly less than 1, this interval we are considering. So it is the customarily it is written this way in integration. When the endpoints are not well behaved, so we replace these points with this way and take the limit of the total integral. Take the limit of the total integral, okay? So epsilon tends to 0 plus, delta tends to 0 plus means they are slightly greater than 0 and we are integrating from epsilon to 1 minus delta. Now put 1 minus x is equal to y. What will happen? First of all, please note that how the range will change. If you put epsilon, hello? Hello?
Sir, some students
everybody can hear me?
Some students are waiting.
Oh, that's noise. Okay. Then 1 minus x equal to y, if I put x is equal to epsilon, first of all, see how the lower range is changing. If you take epsilon, so y will be 1 minus epsilon. So this lower range will be changed to 1 minus epsilon. And if I put x is equal to 1 minus delta, so the upper range will be delta. 1 minus delta, that is delta. So y will be delta. Okay, so this will be 1 minus epsilon to delta. Now, what is dx? Minus dx is equal to dy. So what is dx? Minus dy. So this dy, there will be one minus sign. And what we know, you know already from the property of definite integral, a to b fx dx is equal to minus b to a fx dx, isn't it? A to b fx dx, if we reverse the range, one minus sign will be occurred. Is that very clear? It has already been discussed and understood in the earlier classes. I hope everybody could understand this thing. A to b fx dx is equal to minus b to a fx dx. That means if I get minus 1 minus epsilon to delta, that will be equal to delta to 1 minus epsilon minus will be absorbed. And this x will be 1 minus y whole to the power m minus 1. And this 1 minus x will be y whole to the power m minus 1. Is that clear to all? Then I am getting back the same beta function with only change in the position of the parameter. In now y to the power n minus 1 and 1 minus y to the power m minus 1. The same thing, 0 to 1, this one. So that is equal to basically beta nm. Okay.
Sir, someone waiting, sir.
Why they don't join in one plot, I don't understand. Amir ko tabhi ghusa hai, abhi kya hua? Okay. So this part is okay. No confusion, no question. In this calculation, everybody is clear?
Yes,
please,
sir.
Make sure. No problem. Anybody is having any question? Please tell me.
No, sir.
Okay. This is very simple. Straightforward. You just put 1 minus x is equal to y. Everything will be calculated automatically. You have to just use some elementary properties of definite integral, like a to b fx dx is equal to minus b to a, and like this. So it will be very clear. And this is the way limit the improper integrals are written in this way. So this is also known to you. So beta mn is equal to beta nm, that we have first put. Second property, second result is gamma 1 equal to e to the power integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus x dx. Okay. So that is obviously because if you put gamma, what is gamma n? What is gamma n? E to the power minus x, x to the power n minus 1. So if we put n equal to 1, so x to the power n minus 1 will be x to the power 0, that is 1. X to the power 0 is 1, and e to the power minus x will be left. And what is the integration of e to the power minus x? Tell me. What is the integration of e to the power minus x? Response, anyone? What is the integration of e to the power minus x? Nisha? Tamanna?
Sir, minus e to the power minus x?
Minus e to the power minus x. So you take so much time. It is not expected. This is a very simple integral. What about others? Nobody could respond this thing. Very simple. E to the power minus x integration is minus e to the power minus x. Simple. E to the power mx is m e to the power 1 by m e to the power mx integration. The differentiation is m e to the power mx. Okay. So this will be e to the power minus x. Now again, I have already told you this is a improper integral. So I will write this thing as epsilon to b this way. I will write where epsilon tends to 0, b tends to infinity this way. So this way I'm writing epsilon to b e to the power minus x, x to the power n. So if x is, if n is 1, it is not actually, this is the defined property. Okay, I'm just going to say wrong line. Let us calculate this thing first. E to the power minus x, so 0 to infinity. Okay, so now I'm getting integration is minus e to the power minus x. Now tell me, minus e to the power minus x from epsilon to b, what will be that thing? Okay, let me write it again. So e to the power minus x and x to the power n minus 1 is already 0, that we have understood, and this will be 0 to infinity. Okay, so this is the thing. I hope everybody can see it.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now this can be written in the way I write improper integral LT, okay, not LT this way. Let me write this way. This one. So here LT, then what is that? B tends to infinity. B tends to infinity and epsilon tends to, what is epsilon? Here is epsilon tends to 0. And what we are getting here, this entire integral written this way. Epsilon 2, this will be epsilon, and this will be b. Is that okay? This is also dx. Is that okay? Everybody is clear? This way we write the improper integral. Okay. Now, next what we do, that will be equal to, that will be equal to integration. What is the result of integration? We already know integration is minus e to the power minus x. Okay. So I write this thing as minus e to the power minus x. Minus e to the power minus x from 0 to infinity. So from b to epsilon to b. First of all, you write this way, from epsilon to b this way. This will be from epsilon to b. Here I am writing b and here I am writing epsilon. Okay, so this is the thing. Now what will be that? That will be equal to, again, limit of same thing here. What we get? Sorry, b will be here, na? Sorry. B will be here. B tends to infinity, and this will be epsilon. Sorry, this will be epsilon. Now that will be equal to minus e to the power. What will be that? Minus b, and then again minus, and this minus will make it plus. Is it clear to all? Minus plus e to the power minus epsilon. Okay, now tell me, e to the power minus b, that will go to, okay, you have any idea what is the value of e? E is the universal constant known as Euler's constant. So what is the value of e? Do you know? Anyone? What is the value of e?
It is not
necessary to tell you to remember the value exactly, because there is no end of it. This is an irrational number like pi. What is pi? It is a number between 3 to 4. But can you ever be able to write it completely? It is 3.141756. This way it will never end. Similarly, e is a value within 2 to 3. So now this will be, now e is a 2 to 3, and 2 to 3 whole to the power minus b is 1 by 2 to the power b. Not 2, 1 by e to the power b, where e is a value greater than 2. Now tell me, if b tends to infinity, then e to the power b, that will go to, suppose e is 2, so 2 to the power infinity will go to infinity, obviously. So 1 by 2 to the power b, that will go to 0. So 1 by e to the power b, this will be simply going to 0. Clear or not? E to the power b, that will be going to 0. Because 1 by e to the power infinity, tending to b tends to infinity. So e to the power infinity is a value greater than 2. Suppose it is just 2. So 2 to the power infinity, even this is 0. Actually infinity, so 1 by that is 0. I hope it is clear to all.
Yes sir.
And what about this e to the power minus epsilon? Epsilon tends to 0, so e to the power 1 by e to the power epsilon. So 1 by e to the power 0 in the limit. So e is a non-zero value. E, whatever be the value, it is a value within 2 to 3. Non-zero value to the power 0. What is the value?
1.
Any non-zero value to the power 0 is always 1. 0 to the power 0 is not defined, but non-zero value to the power 0 is 1. So it will be again 1 by 1, that is 1. So total result is, tell me, what is the total result?
1.
What is the total result?
1.
I hope everybody is clear.
Yes.
No confusion?
Yes, sir.
Someone is entering. She thought. You have any confusion? Anyone?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Everybody can see it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So then this result is already proved. This result is proved. This one. So gamma 1 equal to e to the power minus x dx equal to 1. Oh. Now, next property. Property 3. What is property 3? Okay, property 3 is very important property, gamma n plus 1 equal to n gamma n, where n is any positive value greater than 0. N gamma n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n. And it will immediately follow from this property that when n is a positive integer, when n is a positive integer, suppose n is equal to 5, so what will happen? So gamma n plus 1, that is gamma 6, is equal to 5 gamma 5. Again, gamma 5 equal to, by the same property, gamma 5 equal to 4 gamma 4. Again, gamma 4 equal to 3 gamma 3. So what will be the result for gamma 6? Gamma 6 equal to
5.
The result? Gamma. You just calculate on a paper. Haan, bolo.
5 gamma 5.
Only 5. Gamma 6 is 5 gamma 5. Then gamma 5 is 4 gamma 4. The same property. Gamma 4 is 3 gamma 3. So where they will end? Gamma 1 up to gamma 2. Gamma 2 is 1 gamma 1. And what is gamma 1? What is the value of gamma 1? We have just shown. What is gamma 1? 1?
1.
Gamma 1 is 1. So what is the ultimate result of this gamma n plus 1? Tell me.
N gamma 1. N gamma n.
No, no. If I take n equal to say 5. So it will be gamma 6. Na? Gamma 6 is equal to 5 gamma 5. Again, using the same property, gamma 5 is equal to 4 gamma 4, gamma 4 equal to 3 gamma 3, gamma 3 is equal to 2 gamma 2, gamma 2 is equal to 1 gamma 1, and gamma 1 equal to 1. So what I'm getting basically, gamma 6 so equal to
120.
1.
That means factorial 5, na? Why batao na? Factorial 5. Factorial 5 is 120.
Yes, sir.
That means gamma n plus 1 is factorial n when n is integer, positive integer. This will follow from this property also. That is why I am trying to explain. Are you getting it? This is the general property for any n, not necessarily integer. Not necessarily integer, this property should hold. Gamma n plus 1 is equal to n gamma n. And if in particular n is a positive integer, then we have gamma n plus 1 is equal to factorial n. This I want to say. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us prove this result, how this general result is coming. So gamma n plus 1 is equal to 0 to infinity e to the power minus x, x to the power n. Okay. What was the definition of gamma n? What was the definition of gamma n? 0 to infinity e to the power minus x, x to the power n minus 1. So if you put instead of n, if you put n plus 1, So that will be gamma n plus 1 is equal to e to the power minus x to the power n plus 1 minus 1. That is x to the power n. Is that okay? X to the power n plus 1 minus 1. But in the definition, I am just putting n equal to n plus 1. So that means gamma n plus 1 equal to 0 to infinity e to the power minus x to the power n d. Again, as usual, I will write this thing as epsilon to beta e to the power minus x to the power n, where epsilon tends to 0 plus beta tending to infinity. So now we try to integrate this thing. So we make an integration by parts. Integration by parts, taking x to the power n as the first function. So when x to the power is the first function, integration of second function, that is e to the power minus x, that will be minus of e to the power minus x, simple. So this is the first term of the integration by parts. It minus e to the power minus x to the power n epsilon to beta plus. Then differentiation of x to the power n, that is n x to the power n minus 1 into minus of e to the power minus x. This minus and here one minus will make it plus. Is that okay? So this is the result of integration by parts. Now the first term will be 0 simply. E to the power minus x to the power n, that will be simply 0. And the second term will be n into epsilon to beta e to the power minus x to the power n minus 1. What is that? This is nothing but the gamma n. This is nothing but gamma n. So that means gamma n plus 1 will be equal to n gamma n. Okay. So this is the third property. Then, okay, these things they have shown that this thing will be zero. These are standard results. It can be seen in any book of analysis. These results are zero. So this is the results. And property four, writing kx instead of x, we can easily show that 0 to infinity e to the power minus kx x to the power n minus 1, that equal to gamma n by k to the power n. Gamma n by k to the power n, property number 4. Okay, this let us show these things again. So I'm getting this result. E to the power kx and x to the power n minus 1. Okay. Now put kx equal to y. Kx equal to y. Then what will happen? Tell me. Someone is again knocking the door. Who is that person? So kx equal to y. That means this will imply k dx is equal to dy. So what will happen? The integral will become, and obviously at k, x is equal to 0, y is 0, x equal to infinity, k is infinity. So this will be, integral will change to e to the power minus y, and this x will be y by k. So instead of x, I'm writing y by k. Y by k whole to the power n minus 1 into, now what is dx? Dx will be 1 by k dy. So again 1 by k dy. Is that okay? Everybody is clear? After changing x to y, I get this thing.
Yes, sir.
So that is equal to, now what is the total power of k? Tell me, what is the total power of k? K to the power n minus 1 and k. So k to the power n So I can write this thing as one by one by k to the power n. One by k to the power n. Then what is the result of the integration? Okay, this will be deleted, and this will be k will be deleted. Only y whole to the power n minus 1. So this is the thing. What is that? Again, this is nothing but the gamma function, 0 to infinity e to the power minus y, what is n minus 1 gamma function by k to the power n. So this will be simply gamma function by k to the power n. Okay. Everybody is clear? I hope everybody can see this thing. Any question from anyone?
No, sir.
Okay. So I have this result again, e to the power minus k to n minus 1 dx due to infinity equal to gamma n by k to the power n. Okay. Result 5, beta mn equal to gamma m into gamma n by gamma m plus n. Okay. Beta mn equal to gamma m into gamma n by gamma m plus n. And obviously, beta nm, if I interchange beta m and n, that will not change. This will support this result also, gamma n into gamma m. Same thing in the numerator, and the denominator gamma n plus m, again the same thing. Okay, so beta nm is equal to beta mn also supported. Now this is result number 5. Okay, later I will show this result. If I have time, I will show you, but these proofs are not necessary, but you just need to know these things and use them in the problem. Result number 6 is another very important result, gamma m into gamma 1 minus m. For any m within 0 to 1, m must be a proper fraction, 1, 2, 1 third, 2 third, 1 fifth, 4 by 7, 1, whatever it is. So m is a proper fraction, positive, not negative. So gamma m into gamma 1 minus m, that is pi cosec m pi. Pi cosec m pi or pi by sin m pi. Now from that, one very important result can be found. It is gamma half equal to root pi. So if you put m equal to half, so in the left hand side, it will be gamma half into gamma half. Okay. Gamma half into gamma half, that is gamma half square. And in the right hand side, it will be pi by sine pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 is 1, so it will be simply pi. So gamma half square is pi, gamma half equal to root pi. This is one very important result. Frequently, you need to use this result in other problems also. So remember this result. We can alternately deduce the same result using this property 4. Okay, this property. Property 5. Using the property 5, this was property 6. So property 5, I can use this thing to get this result. So in the property 5, put m and n equal to half. M equal to n equal to half. So gamma m into gamma n, that will be gamma half into gamma half, that is gamma half square. And gamma m plus n, that will be gamma 1, that is 1. So it will be gamma half square. Okay. And in the left hand side, it will be beta half half, m equal to half, n equal to half. So beta half half. So beta half half is by definition x to the power minus half and 1 minus x whole to the power minus half, 0 to 1. Now you put x is equal to sine square theta. So this x to the power minus half, that will be sine square theta to the power minus half, that is 1 by sine theta. Is that clear? Sine square theta whole to the power minus half, that is sine theta to the power minus 1, that is 1 by sine theta. And 1 minus x equal to 1 minus sine square, that is cos square whole to the power minus half, that is 1 by cos theta. And dx is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. That means this integral will become 2 sine theta cos theta by sine theta cos theta, that is only 2. And this range will be changed to 0 to pi by 2, because at x is equal to 0, theta is 0, at x is equal to pi by x equal to 1, theta will be pi by 2. So 0 to pi by 2 twice d theta, that is equal to twice of pi by 2, that is pi. So gamma half square equal to pi, gamma half equal to root pi again. I hope everybody is clear.
Yes,
no
sir.
Confusion?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So another very important result on gamma beta function is that beta mn equal to 0 to infinity x to the power m minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power m plus n, or x to the power n minus 1 by 1 plus x whole to the power m plus n. Now we have some more standard results like 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power p theta cos to the power q theta, that is equal to gamma p plus 1 by 2 gamma q plus 1 by 2 by twice gamma p plus q plus 2 by 2. This p should be in small letter, p plus q plus 2 by 2. Okay, this is having some condition, p greater than minus 1, q greater than minus 1. This is coming from the definition again. So actually let us solve this thing in this way. Left hand side I can write this way, sine square theta whole to the power p by 2 and 1 minus sine square theta whole to the power q by 2. I can write this thing in the left hand side. And if I put x equal to sine square theta, I get x to the power p plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Okay, x to the power p by 2 minus 1 whole to the power minus 1 and 1 minus x whole to the power q plus 1 by 2 minus 1 dx. Where from it is getting? Should I calculate this thing again? See, there, what is the dx? What is the dx value? 2 sin theta cos theta. Now, sin theta, here is 1 sin to the power p by 2 into p. So p, that means, again, sin theta will be added. Again, sin theta will be added. Sin to the power p plus 1. Sin to the power p theta cos to the power q theta, and I'm writing sin to the power p theta, I'm writing sin square theta whole to the power p by 2, or my sin square theta by q by 2. Now sin square theta is x, so x to the power p by 2, x to the power p by 2 into dx, dx equal to 2 sin theta cos theta. Then what will be the value of theta? What will be the value of theta? D theta, tell me. Dx by sine theta, 2 sine theta cos theta. That 2 will come here, half, and by sine theta cos theta. By sine theta means sine to the power minus 1. So it will become x to the power p plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Similarly, 1 minus x whole to the power q plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Because sin theta cos theta will be in the numerator. Okay. Are you getting or you are confused? Okay, let me show this thing again. Half. Zero to pi by two. This should be pi by 2, and this is equal to sin whole to the power p theta. Sin whole to the power p theta and cos whole to the power q theta. d theta. Is that okay? Now you are writing, what you are writing, putting, put x is equal to sine square theta. Sine square theta. Okay. So what is dx? What is dx? That is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. 2 sine theta cos theta. So that is equal to what you can write this thing as dx equal to, sorry, 2 sine theta cos theta d theta. So d theta is equal to, d theta is equal to dx by total, half you are taking outside, okay, half you are taking outside, one half will be there in the outside. And dx by, okay, let me write this in a clear way. This way should I write? So it should be, there will be dx, there will be sine theta cos theta. Now tell me, what is sine theta? Root x. What is sine theta? Root x. Okay. So this will be root of x. And what is cos theta? Tell me.
Root over 1 minus x.
Because x is sine square theta. 1 minus cos square theta is cos theta. Now we put everything in the equation here. So our integration will become, how the integration will become? Now, this integration will change to, tell me. This integration will change to, when x is equal to theta is equal to 0 is, 0 and pi by 2 is 1, so this will be 1, and sine to the power p theta, that will be sine theta is equal to root x. Okay, it will be, what will be that? Root x whole to the power p theta, so that means x to the power p by 2, is that okay? X to the power p by 2, and this will be, theta is cancelled, and this will be cos theta. Cos theta is basically 1 minus x, 1 minus x root all to the power q by 2, sorry, q by 2, into dx, and what is dx? Into d theta. D theta will be replaced by dx by this, so dx by, okay, now entire thing I am writing in the numerator, so it will be 1. Great numerator, write it in the Here I am writing this one, and here I am writing this one. Is that okay now? So this half will be coming outside. This half will be coming outside. And here, what we have? Tell me, x to the power p by 2 minus half. So it will be x to the power p by 2. This half is cancelled. X to the power half minus so p by 2 minus half. So you will write this way. X by p by 2 minus so x, half.
So x to the power p minus 1 by 2.
P minus 1 by 2.
Yes.
P minus 1. Where from it is coming? P minus 1 by 2. Sine to the power p theta. So x to the x is sine square theta. So sine theta will be root x. So root x whole to the power p. So p by 2. P by 2 minus half. So p minus 1 by p minus 1 by 2. P minus 1 by 2. We are getting, but it is not messing with the thing. What is given here? It is okay. P actually, if you add this thing, p plus 1 minus 2 by 2. That is p minus 1 by 2. Okay, it is okay. So p minus 1 by 2. So you can write this way also. It will be p minus 1 by 2. And this will be q minus 1 by 2. Okay?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Q minus 1 by 2. And this will be...
Sir.
Needed.
Sir.
Follow?
Again, explain, sir, p minus 1 by 2 and q minus 1 by 2.
What I am telling, x is equal to sine square theta, so sine theta is equal to root x, x to the power half, so sine
yes,
to the power p theta, ki habe? X to the power p by 2, x
yes,
to the power
sir.
P by 2, and yes, this sir. Will be cos to the power q theta, that is 1 minus x whole to the power q by 2, because cos q theta is actually 1 minus sine square is cos square, so 1 minus x, and cos square, that will be through cos square whole to the power q by 2. Cos square whole to the power q by 2, that means 1 minus x, 1 minus sine square whole to the power q by 2. And d theta will be equal to dx by 2 root x root over 1 minus x from this. Okay, dx is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. So d theta is equal to dx by 2 sine theta cos theta. What is sine theta? Root x. What is cos theta? Root under 1 minus x. So this is the thing. Then just equate the power of similar term. Now this p minus 1 by 2, that can be written as p plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Why I am writing this thing? I am trying to identify this thing with the beta function. What I am trying, this p minus 1 by 2, I want to write this thing as p plus 1 by 2 minus 1. Okay. Why? Because I want to keep it in the form x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1. This I want to do. That is why I am writing this way. Okay. So I want to write this way. This will be, I will write then x p plus 1 by 2 minus 1. And this will be q plus 1 by 2 minus 1. So this is just like x to the power m minus 1 and 1 minus x to the power n minus 1, okay? So that will be equal to half again. This half will be there. And what will be that? This gamma beta p plus 1 by 2 q plus 1 by 2. Beta p plus 1 by 2. And q plus 1 by 2. Now you are sure? And that will be equal to again half of gamma m plus gamma n by gamma m plus n. That is gamma p plus 1 by 2. Class question. Bolo class question. Bolo class question. So beta p plus 1 by 2 q plus 1 by 2. Okay, that is equal to gamma p plus 1 by 2 into gamma q plus 1 by 2 by gamma p plus q plus 2 by 2. I think everybody is clear to that. No confusion?
Yes, sir.
No question from anyone? Okay, then. So this is the thing. Beta p plus 1 by 2, q plus 1 by 2, that is the right hand side equal to this. Okay. And lastly, 0 to pi by 2 sine to the power p theta d theta, that is equal to 0 to pi by 2 cos to the power p theta d theta, and that is equal to root pi by 2 gamma p plus 1 by 2 by gamma p plus 2 by 2. This is just follows from the last one, where if I take q is equal to, that's q plus 1 by 2, that is equal to 0. That is equal to 0. P plus 1 by 2, that is equal to 0. Okay. If I take Q plus 1 by 2 equal to 0, what we get? We get only sine to the power P theta. And that will be called a root pi by 2 gamma P plus 1 by 2 and gamma Q plus 1 by 2, that is, not 0, sorry. That should be equal to 1. That should be equal to Q plus 1 by 2, that should be equal to, basically, I am getting gamma half, na? Gamma half is root pi. Okay, so that should be half. So I should take gamma Q plus 1 by 2 is equal to half. That is Q is equal to 0. If I take Q is equal to 0. Okay, if I take Q is equal to 0, then Q plus 1 by 2, that will be simply gamma half. And gamma half is root pi, we have already deduced. Already is gamma half is equal to root pi. And this will be gamma of p plus q plus 2 by 2, that is p plus 0 plus 2 by 2, that is p plus 2 by 2. And by symmetry, this cos to the power p theta d theta will be same. 0 to pi by 2, that will be same. Okay. Just you remember that q should be equal to 0. So q plus 1 by 2 will be equal to half. So the result will follow by remembering gamma half equal to root pi. And last property we will discuss, e to the power minus x square 0 to infinity dx is root pi by 2. That is also, this is called Euler Poisson integral. This integral is known as Euler Poisson integral. Okay. Now, independently, using your ordinary method, we cannot evaluate this type of integral. It is not possible by any technique, by substitution, by integration, by parts. Anyway, you cannot evaluate this thing. You have to resort to gamma function. So let us see how we can apply gamma function to evaluate this thing. You just put x square is equal to z. What is the purpose? Because I want to put here e to the power minus z. What is the form of gamma function? E to the power minus x, x to the power n minus 1. So I put x square is equal to z. So 2x is equal to 2x dx equal to dz. So dx will be equal to dz by 2x. That is dz by 2 root x. Dz by 2 root x. That means this will become half of e to the power minus z, and this z to the power half minus 1. Okay, z to the power half minus 1 dz, simple. And that will be equal to, then actually it is z to the power minus half, and z to the power minus half is half minus 1. That is n equal to half, that is equal to gamma half. So gamma half is equal to root pi by 2. So the result of the integral is root pi by 2. So all these results you should remember when you will solve some more problems. Okay, so we are finishing today. I will not discuss anymore. Just I have discussed some properties of gamma beta function. You just work on that, practice these properties, and calculate these results or proofs by your own. And in the next class, we will start some problems from gamma beta function. Okay. So bye, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. And everybody give your attendance through Google form.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone. Okay. Give your attendance and go away. Bye.